Yogendra, so just to ask you that, you know, obviously, given the fact that there have been these protests, it's quite likely that the government will gesture towards the agriculture sector, towards the farming community. What are you expecting the government to say about any of these things? And also, what would you like them to say versus what you think they may actually say?
Vasu, gesture is the word. Last few budget speeches, which we've analyzed very closely, as you know, every time we analyze the budget from the point of view of the farmers. And every time we've had gestures, lovely words, good dialogues, but very little allocation. So I would not look at gestures, I would look at allocations. And I'm not sure if which is going to make much of a difference. So what would I expect? I would expect one information. Now, this is the 5 years have been completed of the 6-year mission of doubling of farmers' income. I would expect the government to at least tell me where have the farmers' income reached. Not double, sure, but has it been increased 75%, 80%, 50%, 60%? For the last 5 years, the government has not released a single piece of information on this. That's one thing I would expect. What would I hope? I would hope that the government would put in substantial resources for ensuring that farmers get decent price. That always been an issue, Vasu, because everyone looks at procurement. Now, procurement is clearly one method, but there are methods other than procurement which the government can use to shore up the prices of agricultural commodities. Sadly, the allocation for that particular scheme, its market intervention scheme, has been abysmal and has not really worked at all. So will the government put in more money to ensure that farmers get their get decent price? That's one thing I would keep an eye on. I would also wish to see what the government has to say on things like MGNREGA, because MGNREGA's budget has been over-exhausted this year. What kind of budget are they allotting today is something we need to see. And I'm really hoping that there would not be any discrepancy between the budget speech and the allocation tables, which, as you know, has been the case in the last couple of speeches, which is a fiscal scandal in any country that takes some pride on its economy.
Right. But since you're here, let me also ask you this, that, you know, that had things gone according to plan, the groups, the farmer groups were, in fact, planning to hold another march to Parliament today, but that was suspended because of the violence on Republic Day. But as far as the groups are concerned, regardless of what happens in the budget, you are steadfast on your demand for the repeal of the bill. The Prime Minister did mention that he stands by the decision to suspend the bills for 1.5 to 2 years as per the Supreme Court's directions. But the protest will continue. So even today, we will see the protest continue tomorrow and onwards.
Vasu, there is no reason to withdraw the protest. There is no reason to change our demands. I do welcome the Prime Minister's gesture. Prime Minister saying that doors for negotiation are open, and I want to assure everyone that farmers have never closed the doors for negotiation. So, yes, we are very much in. As soon as the government thinks they can be, negotiations can be started, we are very happy to participate. And I just hope that the government would not simply reiterate what they said on the 20th. That they would be willing to take a couple of steps forward. And I can assure you, if the government does, farmers would not be found wanting in accommodating.